Never plant your tree like this, or this, or this. And I will get back to why that's bad. But today, among other things, I'm gonna give you everything you need to pick the right tree and make a great hole.
Mine is deep and skinny.
I got a big fat hole.
Right. We're planting trees today. Today, I'm going to show you all of the steps to plant a tree the right way. And it's not rocket science, but you can definitely do it wrong.
Hey everybody, Rob Nelson here, Stone Age Man. We got Jonas Stenstrom over here as well. He's coming to help me plant some trees because today, we, as biologists, we're gonna show you how to properly plant a tree. Team Trees is going off right now, 20 million trees by the end of the year. If you don't know about that campaign, check the links below. Donate to plant some trees yourself. But if you can, and this is the best thing you can do, go out, get yourself a tree and put it in the ground on your property and help habitat there. But you gotta get the right tree. And of course, that's why we went to Lowe's, was to look for native trees.
Native trees, that's where we're going. The reason I feel so strongly about this is that I used to work as an ecologist. I propagated and planted native plants to help produce healthy ecosystems.
The thing people don't understand is that this is the time to buy this tree. It looks so dead. This is a native eastern redbud. We're gonna make this grow.
You can get a lot of these cheaply at your home improvement store, like Home Depot, Lowe's, or your local garden center.
$13.
$13?
$13.
Tree?
Eastern redbud.
But you have to know what you're looking for because they also sell a lot of exotic species. The native ones are going to be the best. I've chosen a native eastern redbud tree, and this is actually a pretty good time to plant these trees. And this is where a little bit of knowledge about each tree will go a long ways. Unfortunately, Lowe's and Home Depot mostly don't tell you which trees are native, so you have to do a little bit of research.
You gotta have the right tree. That's super important.
Good ones in the eastern US might be redbuds, maples, sweet gums, among others. But all you need to remember right now is that you're looking for native trees.
First step, find the right location.
I'm trying to establish a nice understory here, and I know it can handle a little bit of shade. That's why I'm planting it right here. But that's where you can do a search and figure out your tree's requirements. In doing so, I did find out that it needs good drainage, and that leads me to the next thing, the importance of the hole.
Second step, dig the hole.
Now, digging the hole and prepping the soil are some of the most important things that you can do when planting any plant. We're going to dig this hole 2 to 3 times as wide as the pot diameter. And we're going to be digging just deep enough that the top of this tree's root flare is right at soil level.
Then we're going to add really good soil. In our case, we picked up a couple of bags of tree and shrub soil, which is a lot more organic than the material that's here. This is very hard and rocky and clay. This will help the tree in those first few years really establish itself. Now we know it already grows well here. There's a couple of eastern redbuds already in the forest, but this is just a really good practice. And we're gonna make sure that the soil's well drained and go from there.
And then I'll put the tree in just like so. And the key is you wanna make sure that the height of your tree is about the height of the soil around it. Okay, you don't wanna mound up a bunch of soil on top of it. You wanna keep this right at the surface. So that's why we're right where we're at. Okay, now we just have to bring in some of the dirt we brought out, mix it in with the organic stuff, and it will be a good soil mixture for this tree to grow in.
Spending time on the hole is extremely important. Gardeners will often joke about how they spend more on the hole than they often do on the plant. And this is because spending the time to amend the soil is going to pay off for the plant in the long run. Once you've filled in the hole, it's time to add a thin layer of mulch on top. You definitely don't want to mound the mulch around the base of the tree. If you do this, first the tree's roots will start to grow up into that mulch. That moisture also encourages fungus and other plant pests on the trunk of the tree. It's gonna be really bad for the tree in the long run. And I know a lot of people see this in landscaping practices and mimic it, but it's not a good practice. Finally, water in the tree to settle the soil. And I hope at least you learned you can't just dig a hole the size of your pot and stick it in. And I hope you're paying attention to what tree you're planting because it matters for a thriving ecosystem. The Team Tree Initiative pushes hard the 20 million tree number, but we need the right trees. And that's why the Arbor Day Foundation is handling the donations. They know which trees to plant and how to plant them. My push is that you should be planting trees yourself on your own property. Find native ones, dig a good hole, and make sure they can thrive. And don't forget to donate to Team Trees. I do all of this and make videos like this to try to encourage an understanding of the environment that you live in, and that we make sure we're the best stewards we can here on planet Earth.
Thank you.
Also, thank you, patrons. I really appreciate you supporting this wildlife education. If you want to help support too, I encourage you to go down to the Patreon link below. It's currently how I'm helping make this whole thing possible. And I'm currently sending out postcards as an extra way to say thank you.